into English or French and give to someone who is not Muslim. Try and read this and see what is there. Or buy a pamphlet of the deen and give someone. Most of us have 10 or 5 Qurans in the home collecting dust. Even to take some of them and bring to the masjid, or buy copies of the Quran, bring to the masjid for a Muslim, fellow Muslim to read. We don't do it. Because we believe the deen, Allah will take care of it, we have nothing to do. That is not right. He will guide whom he will to guide. But it's we, the Muslim, who say we are Muslim, we are the one who to have to spread this deen. Otherwise, Allah will ask us about it. He will ask us. Especially the Quran. So the point the Prophet said, Ya Rabbi, inna qawmi ittaghadu hadha al-Quran mahjura. He will complain, the Prophet, that, oh Allah, my people boycotted the Quran. We have to spread it, brothers. Leaving a Quran after you die, anyone who read it, Allah will give you the reward. At the end, he said, أَوْ تَرَكَ وَلَدًا يَسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهِ. Or you leave a son after you, or a daughter, who will ask Allah to forgive you? That means as another investment. So you teaching your kids Quran or the deen is your own benefit, not them. It's you. You have to know that. And we have all the Saturdays and Sundays to take them to Islamic schools for 2 hours. Even that, most of us don't do. Busy work. While the public schools, we will wake up 4 in the morning. 4 in the morning. Preparing them for to go to school. Asking them, do you eat? Do you take your bath? Do you do homework? Not all we'll ask them every day, 5 days a week. But just to take them 2 hours or 3 hours to go study the deen of Allah, we're busy. While if they have PhD in science, in medicine, if they didn't pray for you, it's a loss for you. You teaching them the deen, telling them it's your right upon them to pray for you when you pass, it's your own investment. It's your own benefit. Not them, you. Because the Prophet said, if you die, your son or your daughter is praying for you, Allah will give you that reward. So this deen, brothers and sisters, is something which we have to honor. Especially the symbols of the deen. And the one of the biggest symbols is the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you take care of the masjid of Allah, you sponsor it, you do it for the sake of Allah. Don't look at the money or at the people who work in there. You just say in your heart, you're doing it for the sake of Allah. This is for Allah. Allah, I'm investing this for you to take care of me in my grave and in the next life. Or take care of my parents or my family. He will do it. Because it's the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, he will give you your share. He will give you a house. He will build you a palace if you take care of his house. And the most beloved places on earth, the Prophet said, is the masajid of Allah. And the places he hate the most is the markets, where we love the most, because there we make money. In the masjid, Allah loved the most. He hate this, the workplace or the shop or the market, the worst, the most. He hate it. We do the opposite. The masjid will come only Friday to Friday. But the market, we will work up 6 to 11 to 2 to 12 hours, 24 hours. We're happy because we're making money. The masjid, we come Friday to Friday. Even coming to pray in the masjid. One day, volunteer to come and clean the masjid. Seeing something wrong and repair it. Coming and ask, did the masjid pay its bills? Here's something to pay the bills of the masjid of Allah. It's an investment, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, it will benefit us. Wallahi, the cars we have don't benefit us in the qabr. Wallahi, those high buildings and big lots or big houses back home we have don't benefit us. It won't. Most of it will give us hard time because we don't know the halal from haram. Most of us, alhamdulillah, now we say alhamdulillah ala kulli halin wa a'udhu billahi, we don't care. Let me only give the money and buy a big house there and build it. I don't care if it's halal or haram. And we will be a caution about it. But the masjid of Allah, the pen you invest from halal, Allah will take care of it and build it for you and increase it for you. And he will pay you a reward which none of your good deeds will match it. Because as we say, your salat will stop when you die. But the masjid we build for Allah will continue. You will get the reward in the grave, in your next life, and he will reward the Jannah for it. So let's do it. I have it, brother. Every Jummah you go, every masjid you go, especially if you come to this one, make it a habit. Not only $2, brothers, because it's your own benefit. It's for your family members. At least make it a habit to pay in the month what you pay more than your phone bills. At least $10 every week, that means $40. It's less than your cable bill. If you count it yearly, brothers, I sat with the brothers, we count. I found some of them paying $1,500 just for cable. When we ask ourselves, how much you give the masjid? Oh, some of us say, okay, at the fundraising we give $100 the whole year. Or we give only $1, $2 every time we come to the masjid. If we count it, it won't be $365. While we pay in a cable bill, $1,500. So as a Muslim, wasting your life, wasting your money is something Allah will ask you about. May Allah guide us to this deen. May Allah give us the right understanding of this deen. May Allah give us the iman to follow the step of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina adhab an-nar. Allahumma habbib ilayna al-iman wa zayyinhu fi qulubina. Allahumma habbib ilayna al-iman wa zayyinhu fi qulubina. Wa karrih ilayna al-kufr wa al-fusuq wa al-isyan wa ij'alna min al-rashidin. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم انصرنا وانصر إخواننا المسلمين في جميع أنحاء العالم اللهم انصرهم وقوي شوكتهم يا رب العالمين وأطعمهم من عندك وأطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف يا رب العالمين اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولوالديهم ولجميع المسلمين والمسلمات ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير وما ذلك عليك بعزيز وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم تسليما Okay, for the sisters who are outside, inshallah, doing their little business, the masjid say they receive what you bring, inshallah, for the masjid. Thank you very much. May Allah reward you Jannah. May Allah make it easy for the rest of us to take care of the masjid. Please close the gaps and let your brothers stand beside you and pray. Come back to the line. Let your brothers squeeze you a little bit, inshallah. Don't feel bad about it. It's just a few minutes.
Go to the line. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي الصلاة حي الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
صلوا صلوا على الناس straightening your line brothers don't forget your cell phone put it up الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر كلا سوف تعلمون ثم كلا سوف تعلمون كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لترون الجحيم ثم لترونها عين اليقين ثم
ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم.
الله
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. سبحان الله.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدعو اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون. الله أكبر.
الله
أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده.
ربنا
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا
الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله.
Please submit in there for the masjid. Don't forget it. If you don't have today, promise next week, inshallah, and the week following weeks, inshallah. Don't forget the masjid. The masjid need your help. Assalamu alaikum.
Bismillah.
Vous avez aidé? Ça va? Enfin, c'est pas un garçon?
Young boy,
bring $20 here. Sabilillah.
You got some money.
Thank you. Sabilillah, help the masjid. Sabilillah. Sabilillah. Ça va bien? D'accord. Ça va bien. Sabilillah. Sabilillah, help the masjid. Sabilillah. Sabilillah. Bismillah help to maintain the masjid. Bismillah. Sabilillah, help the masjid. Young boy.
What's
up? How's it going? Sabilillah, help the masjid. Sabilillah, help for the maintenance. How are you? Sabilillah, jazakallah khairan. Sabilillah, help the masjid. Sabilillah, help for the bills. Sabilillah. Mohamed,
voga.
Sabilillah, help for the masjid. Thank you, brother. JazakAllah. Sabilillah, help the masjid. Sabilillah, help the masjid. Sabilillah, your help is needed for the bill and the maintenance. Sabilillah. Monsieur Fall. Sabilillah. The masjid need your help. Help the masjid. Help the masjid. Sabilillah. Yeah. Bismillah, help the masjid. Bismillah, help to maintain the masjid. Bismillah. Bismillah, help the masjid. Bismillah. Sabilillah, help the masjid. Sabilillah, help to maintain the masjid. Sabilillah. Ça va bien. Merci. Sabilillah. Your help is needed to help. Sabilillah. How much you bring today for the masjid? Where is the $5? How much you bring today? $5 you get? $2 here, that's your bank. Sabilillah, help the masjid. Allah reward you. Sabilillah, help the masjid. Sabilillah. Sabilillah, help the masjid. Masjid need your help for maintenance and bills. Sabilillah.
Not the yellow driver today, please, the Uber driver. Hey, Roman, what do you have to do?
The last time I asked you to send me the stuff, but I didn't give you the number. I don't know if you still have it. Yes, no. The previous one. Just the previous one. Can I give you that? Yeah. I have a WhatsApp, all those stuff on Facebook. How about email? Can I give you that now?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.